I'm Michelle.
I'm Darren. And this is Ollie. Hi.
We just moved actually into the neighborhood about 6 months ago, so we love doing healthy activities. We ride bikes. They love to play soccer.
Part of the thing I'm taking upon myself right now in the new house is landscaping, and I'm not quite sure how to go about doing that. I'm not from Florida. I know a lot of it has to do with irrigation. I don't want to spend a lot of time and energy and money putting plants in the soil only to have them die on me.
The Hagemans are on a mission to create a clean and healthy environment for their family. Michelle has purchased the H2O OK Plus do-it-yourself water test kit from LabTech to check the quality of their water at home.
One of my main concerns is that this is a new house and I'm unfamiliar with the pipes, that there could possibly be lead and copper leaching into our water system.
Hey, hon.
Hey.
What's this?
Okay, so it's a water kit, and it tests for lead, bacteria, chlorine, and the pH levels in our water.
So I just want to check it out, see how our water is.
Smart.
Cool.
I wonder if they have anything for soil.
I did see something there. So they had that and actually quite a few other tests, too. So
interesting.
Yeah, go check it out.
I'm going to head out, so I'm going to stop by and see what I can get.
Okay.
All right. I'll be back.
I did notice on the instructions that there's quite a few tests, but there was two that I really wanted to focus on. Lead was a huge thing for me. And then the other thing was the pH and alkalinity of our water as well, and if there were any contaminants in there. So I stuck with those two for now, and then we'll go from there. Both tests came back negative, lead and pesticides. And the hardness, the chlorine levels, our pH, and the alkalinity of our water, it's all in good standing. So I'm really excited and happy to hear about that.
Darren is on his way to pick up the Soil Master test kit. And while shopping, he also purchases the Mold OK and Radon OK test kits.
Today we're gonna test my soil for four different elements. pH level, nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium to see where I'm at. So the first thing I need to do is prepare the liquid, and this liquid will be used in all of the tests.
Darren follows the easy step-by-step instructions for testing the soil. Within just a few minutes, he's done with all four tests, and the results are in.
Okay, so what I have here are my finished samples. And I've got a color chart that I'm going to compare all my samples to, and it's pretty much gonna give me what I've got going on in my soil. The first one that we have that you saw me do was the nitrogen. And so when I refer to my chart and I put my nitrogen up, it shows that in fact my nitrogen is low. From that, I would determine on what kind of fertilizer I might need or, you know, how I might have to tweak my soil.
The health and safety of their children is the Hagemans' number one priority, and they are concerned that they might have mold throughout their home, which can lead to respiratory problems.
We think we might have some mold underneath the kitchen sink and another spot in the bathroom. So let's do that.
All right.
While Michelle collects the mold spores from the bathroom, Darren takes care of the kitchen area. After collecting the samples, they store them in plastic tray containers, label them, and get them ready for shipment to the lab in the envelope provided.
Okay, perfect. So now we have that radon test, so we can go ahead and get started on that.
Radon is an odorless gas that may cause lung cancer and is unable to be detected without a detection kit. Michelle placed the test sampler on a flat surface, leaving it to sit out for 48 hours. Now that the radon sample is ready, Darren fills out the test form, packs everything into the envelope provided, and mails it out to the lab for the results.
So we got our results back very quickly, I would say.
Within a week.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. I'm really actually happy that they made it extremely simple. So it makes me feel better knowing that, you know, we're eating healthy, but now we're drinking clean water, and we're breathing in, you know, good quality air, and, you know.
And now I can grow things in my garden without them dying.
Yeah, it's awesome.
Yeah, thanks to LabTech, we're much smarter homeowners.
Yeah.
You can visit these websites to learn more about the participants on this edition of Designing Spaces.